Mesh gradient is one of my favorite views that came out in SwiftUI this WWDC. Mesh gradient allows you to create intricate and visually appealing gradients that add depth and sophistication to your user interfaces. By mastering this technique, you can bring a unique, modern aesthetic to your apps, making them more engaging and visually compelling. So let's see how to build one. And if you like my teaching style, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. A link is down in the description. Now, today we are going to talk about how you can create a mesh gradient in the new SwiftUI. You need Xcode beta downloaded for this, and we are going to build out something like this. So let's get to it. Make sure that you have Xcode beta installed on your computer, Xcode 16 beta to be more precise. And let me just show you how easy it is to build this out. And we are also going to make this a little bit more flexible, because all of these meshed gradients, you are going to need to experiment a little bit. So I'm just going to have two colors that we are going to move here and there. Now, how can you imagine this mesh gradient? So let me just go over here back. So think of this as basically a grid, and we have yellow over here, a kind of red over here, a purple, another cyan over here, mint. So we have kind of this grid, and we are going to assign colors to it, and we are going to move those colors alongside that grid. So we are going to have a color X and a color Y for our middle one. So let me just add that into our code, two state variables, and that will be a float. So not the the X value of our colors place in that gradient. Let me duplicate this, and let's have color Y. I'm just going to go in the middle. That's perfectly fine for now. And we are also going to add some sliders to make all of these move. So let me remove these from the V stack, and also the padding, so we can see that nice meshed gradient throughout our device. And let me just add a V stack for our sliders right over here. Let's have a text and then color.x, you know, the x value, as you can see right over there. Let's duplicate this, and then color y, and then two sliders. So our first slider will have a value. I'm just going to use the one with the value, just binding it, $ color X, and then let's duplicate this in color Y, and maybe let's add a padding on this one. There we go. So whenever we are going to move any of these sliders, we are going to effectively move the position of our color X and Y. We will see in just a second where we are putting that color, the actual position of that color. As an iOS developer, having me as your mentor at rebeloper.com/mentoring can significantly elevate your skills and career. With extensive industry experience, I offer personalized guidance, practical insights, and hands-on advice tailored to your needs. Whether you're a beginner or an experienced developer, I help you navigate the complexities of iOS development, build robust applications, and stay ahead of the industry trends. Join me at rebeloper.com/mentoring to enhance your experience and thrive in the competitive world of iOS development. So it's called Mesh Gradient, and as you can see, we have quite a lot of options right over here. I'm going to use the simple one with height points and colors. Now you can have background, smooth colors, color space, all of that stuff. Go ahead and experiment with those. Let's just choose the simplest one. Now, what is this width and height? Well, width and height means basically the columns and rows that we want to add in this grid. 3x3 will be good for us. And then we want to have these points. We want to have this as a two-dimensional array. So I'm going to go like that. And then the colors, again, an array right over here. So currently we can't see anything. Let's just add all of our colors first so you better understand how all of this works. So I'm just going to go with simple colors. So dot black, and then dot black, and then again dot black. Okay, so what does this mean? Well, we are having black right over here, or currently just right over here, and right over here. So the leading part, the middle, and the trailing part of our screen. Now, of course, we can't see it right now, so we want to add it. So let's add our positions for those colors that we have set up. So 0.0. And then we want to have 0.5. So zero, oh, it just broke. Okay, 0.5. That is basically right over here. The leading part and in the center, meaning on the vertical part. And then we want to have 0.5, and then 0.5. So it's just right in the middle of our screen. And then 1.0 and 0.5. Okay, let's just see if that is going to... There we go. Yeah, let me just have here the width, I believe, should be 1. And, I believe maybe that's 3, and then the height would be 1. Of course, now we can't see anything, and I'm going to give it back to 3, because now we have a black, black, and black, but we want to add some more. Let's add a comma right over here. It's still an array, but I'm going to add blue, then blue, and then also another blue right over here. And now we need to also add some points right over here. Again, let's add a comma right over there. And let's go for the bottom half of our screen. So 1.0. And again, it's crashing. Yeah, it's beta software. That's fine. And then right over here, 1.0. So it's all the way up to the bottom. And as you can see now, we already can see some stuff. And then 1.0. Come on, Xcode. So yeah, it looks a little bit quirky right now, but, and you know, blue is at the bottom. I want green at the bottom. So let's add those final 3 layers because, you know, we have a height of 3. So let's have a green right over here, dot green, and then again, dot green. Okay, we don't really see anything, but now our black row, I want to add another row right over here. So all the way to the top, 0.0, comma 0.0. Okay, that's the right over here, right on top. Let's add a comma right over here again. And as you can see now, we are kind of seeing some stuff right over here, 0.5. And again, 0.0, because it's all the way at the top. And then 1.0, so all the way to the trailing part again. And then 0.0. And a comma. Again, this is an array of all of these blocks. And now it looks really, really nice. You can see we just built it out. This is for this first black. This is for the second black right over here. And this is for the third black. Now you just go and, this is for the first blue, second, third. And the third row of greens is this one. Again, this is an array. You may choose the width and height differently. This is just for the tutorial purposes. It looks really nice. And let me just play around with the color X and Y. Now, if I just move this right over here, it doesn't do anything because we did not set up anything in the mesh gradient. Now, what I'm going to do is just choose this middle one, this point that we set up. So this would be color X, and this would be color Y. And as you can see, the default values are still the same, 0.5, which is what I intended to be. Now, if I move this a little bit and this a little bit, you see that it changes quite a lot. And it makes really, really nice effects, these mesh effects. Of course, you see, this doesn't really look that well. So that's why I advise you to experiment with this. You can just put it all the way down into the greens like that and just, you know, experiment what you have. Also, you may add multiple colors, so you don't have to be black, 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 blue, 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 and green, green, green. You can create all of these nice mesh effects by experimenting. Also, you may choose to have more sliders for your experiments. And then you can just add, substitute all of these, usually just the middle parts, not the end parts. And also here you can, please feel free to change these colors. Now, if you do like these tutorial styles, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. We can talk about SwiftUI, Swift iOS development in general, and I will see you in the next one.